Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to customize autocomplete list items, header, and footer using templates. Let's start with the coding part. I will open my existing application, which already has the Syncfusion React dropdowns package installed. On the app.tsx page, I have included the basic autocomplete component rendering code. If you need to know how to create a basic React autocomplete component, you can refer to my Getting Started video linked in the card above or in the description below. When you run this code, you can visualize the employees list. Let's take a quick look at the data I have bound to the data source property of the autocomplete component. Let me run this application and show you the output. Look at the autocomplete component. When I type a character, it shows suggestions. Next, I'll show you how to customize the autocomplete popup list items using the item template property. I declare the method customItems and define the template items with images. I include the image tag with the class name employeeImage and provide the source from the Syncfusion demo sample. Here the images are accessed using the employeeID from the props variable. Then display the employee's name and job with appropriate class names. Next, open the app.css page and define the styles for image, name, and job. Assign this method to the item template property. Look at the autocomplete popup list now. Image, name, and designation have been added to each list item. I can also customize the popup header using the header template property. Create another method, custom header. In the template design, show the header texts, photo, and employee information. I'll assign the class name, header, to this element and column header to this. In the app.css page, define the styles for the classes, header, and column header. Then, assign this custom header method to the header template property. See here, the popup list header has been customized based on the template. I can also customize the footer using the footer template property. Here I'll add another method, custom footer, and add custom text, add new items. Also, I will show the plus icon by adding the span element with the class name e-icons plus. In the app.css page, I specify the content for the plus icon. Assign same properties for footer class. Then assign this custom footer method to the footer template property. Add class name footer to this element. Check now, the autocomplete popup list has a footer based on the provided template. Finally, I will show you how to customize the no records content using the no records template property. By default, autocomplete list shows no records found when no match is found on search. Let me show you what happens when I include the no records template property. I provide the custom content no records available. As you can see, the provided template is displayed when the entered value does not match any of the suggestions in the autocomplete text box. Let me recap what we have seen so far. I showed you how to customize the autocomplete list items, header, and footer using templates. You can download a working example for this video from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license that will provide you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.